Best practices in solar installation. Switch On Foundation promotes best practices in solar pump installations. There are certain do's and don'ts that we need to keep in mind. Drop test needs to be done pre-installation to assess the groundwater level using a water level indicator. Understanding the groundwater level is important to determine the depth of the borewell required or submersible pump, as well as to plan for any groundwater recharging structures if required. Second, a spirit level needs to be used to check the alignment of the mounting structure during installation. Each angle of installation is important for maximum solar energy absorption and structure stability. Third, serial number of solar modules and pumps needs to be noted before installation for warranty purposes. Fourth, the mounting structure needs to be tilted at a fixed angle of 21 to 23 degrees facing south to allow maximum absorption of solar irradiation. This is basically the latitude of the location installation. Fifth, proper installation of the cable joints is required with electrical tapes and waterproof casing. The waterproofing should be checked and rechecked before running the pump. Sixth, to minimize voltage drop, ensure the cables are of adequate diameter. For example, for a 3 HP pump installation, the diameter of cables should be more than 1.5 millimeters. Otherwise, the cables will heat up too much and melt the insulations. Seventh, make sure all the underground accessories are properly insulated and waterproofed wherever required to minimize hazard from shocks and damage of the equipment. Use of thick, flexible conduits ensures protection from rodents destroying pipes and wires. Eighth, the surface pump preferably requires a foundation base to keep the pump. This is done to ensure a smooth surface is available for the pump to be kept and reduces vibration of the pump during operation. The foundation is prepared using M20 grade concrete and 8mm TMT rods. Often, a cover of steel or concrete is made to protect the surface pump from environmental extremes and also keeps the pump safe from theft. Ninth, the technician should wear rubber gloves while making wire connections of the solar module and pump with the pump controller. Better safe than sorry. Lastly, the customer or user needs to be trained on how to operate the system and some basics on troubleshooting.